Hello and welcome to a new OutPower tutorial. Today we'll be talking about the date picker from the OutSystems UI. We'll go over how to use the select date range and how to use the event list property from this widget. Let's get to it, shall we? Today we'll be talking about the date picker that has been made available in the OutSystems UI for the Reactive web applications. The date picker pattern was created using the pickaDate.js library and allows for us to select the date and time using a flat UI to display inline on the screen. It provides several properties that allow us to fine-tune the widget to our liking. But today, we'll focus on the ability to select the date range and to receive a list of events. Our endgame for today will be to produce a demo where we select a range of dates and depending on those, we display the messages that were sent on those days. Let's start by dragging the widget into our page. To do that, we go to OutSystems UI, the folder interaction, and then select the date picker. After dragging the date picker to the page, you'll be prompted to create an event. The inputs for this event will differ depending on what we have set on the property select interval. In our case, we want this property to be set to true to be able to select an interval of time in our date picker. After setting the value of the property, this will create the client action with the necessary inputs to capture the selected date values. To have access to the picked dates, we need to assign the start date and end date to our local client variables. So next we'll create the local variables to store that information. We should also set the default value of the variables as a current date time. For our event list, we'll use an entity that was created previously that has a few message headers that were created on different days. Let's add an aggregate that will fetch all the messages that we'll feed to our event list. Looking at our date picker properties, we set the entity in our event list parameter on event list. This only receives a date time list. We'll use the aggregate that we just created and then map to the correct attribute. Following this, what we need to do is add to our screen the possibility of seeing what are the events that are available for our selected day range. So let's add a two-column structure and a list widget. After that, we add another aggregate for our filtered events. In the aggregate itself, we use the message entity and set the filters to get the messages that were created between the start and end filter dates. Let's also sort our messages by date. Don't forget to set the fetch to only on demand. After finishing with the aggregate, we set it as the source of our list and had the information that we need. Okay, now that we've set our aggregate and information that we need to trigger the refresh. That will happen when we select the dates on our date picker. So after selecting the dates, we'll request the refresh data of our filtered messages. Okay, we have now finished our development. Now all we need to do is publish and let's check our demo. Thank you. As you can see, for the days that we have events, we have a small dot under the number. As we select our day range, we can see the messages that were created on those days. Hope you have enjoyed our tutorial. Now you should be able to understand how to use the select date range and the event list property of the date picker from the OutSystems UI in your Reactive web application. Thank you very much for joining us on this tutorial, and we hope to see you on our next video.